Okay, students, in this video, I'm going to cover setting up a linear equation on Excel spreadsheets versus Google. And I'm going to show you that it's actually a little bit easier, and I don't need that cheat that I used in the last video for Google Sheets. So I just wanted to show you, I'm going to be using the same data. So I'm going to have the same range, and I'm going to have the same domain and the same points. And I'm basically going to use this information and apply it now to Excel. So again, here are the same points. I've already taken the leisure of typing in and everything, and I have it already set up by clicking on this trend line. It pops up, and I already have a linear equation. It's automatic. And what I wanted to show in this video is you can display your equation. And if I look, and I display my equation right here, I see right off the bat the linear equation. But just like on Google Sheets, I have a B, a y-intercept that's not equal to zero. And I can also do the R squared, which shows the correlation, which we see it's really tight because my data is tight. It's fictitious. I made it really tight. You want this as close to one as possible. If I remove this stuff, what I want to show you is I can click here. So instead of typing that equals line estimate, my range, comma, domain, comma, false, I can just set my intercept equal to zero right here just by clicking that box. Now, when I do that, I want you to notice the line, how it slightly changes, right? So when there's not a y-intercept that's set to zero, again, I have a non-zero y-intercept. But just like in that last video, doesn't make sense, right? If my volume is zero, to have a mass of 0.6592 grams. So what do I want to do? I want to set the y-intercept equal to zero. And now when I display it, what do I notice? I get that same 2.67x that I got on my Google Sheets when I use that line estimate. So again, I get the same thing. It is easier if you have Excel to just press that button rather than type up that function. And you get it displayed on the chart, unlike Google Sheets that will not display the corrected one on the chart. So that is the difference. So I hope that makes sense. Again, same thing. If you guys wanted to change your axes and your grid lines. You see here I start at zero and then I go by two. So I see my minimum value is zero. I go all the way up to 10. The major grid lines are two because zero to two. The minors are 0.4. If I want, I could change the majors to one on this axis and I would get that, change it to one. I can do the same thing over here. I see my range is 0 to 30. I have my majors at 5. That's really good. I don't want to change that. My minor is at 1. That's really good. I guess I could show you that you can change this to 10, so it'd be more like the Google Sheets. And it's just so much easier on Excel. But Google Sheets is a great free option. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed these videos and it helps out.